Hello. Welcome. How are you doing? I hope this is a good day for you. We are already having, I think, about just a few more days to the end of the year. So, how have you been? And hope these videos have been helping you. It has been of encouragement to you. Has it encouraged you to say thank you to the Lord? Has it encouraged you to sit back and think of all the things the Lord has done for you? Look, I have so many things written down of all the Lord has done for you. So, do you have a list? Have you, your teachers write the things that Santa you want for Christmas? Have you written down the things that the Lord has done for you from January till this time? Well, if you haven't, I hope this encourages you to do so. Well, by the way, this is your first time. This is Papa's Heart Ministry. My name is Judah, and I welcome you. In this episode, we are having a season of Thanksgiving. So this is 31 days of Thanksgiving in the month of December 2023. It's a time of saying thank you to the Lord for all he has done, all of his greatness, all of his faithfulness, so many things. It's not enough to just say, oh Lord, I thank you. Thank you for this year. Thank you for that. We have to be specific. Thank you for what? Thank you for this. Thank you for that. Oh, thank you for the new hair scarf I got. Thank you for the new lipstick I got. You think he doesn't mind? Those things do not count to him. It does. Oh, you say, but I work for it. He gave you the money. If he didn't help you with that job, you will be out of it by now. So you say thank you for everything. So let's come back to today. Today is day six, and we are being thankful to the Lord for not giving up on me. Yes, I'm thankful to the Lord for not giving up. Please, there's a lot of construction going on at this time in my house, so I'm not going to be raising my voice. I usually don't raise my voice even when I speak anyway, but I'm thankful to the Lord for not giving up on me. Yeah, you know. Growing up as a young girl, I always knew the Lord had a vision and a purpose and plan for me. In fact, I had shared my testimony many times how in going into university, the Lord has said to me that I was not sure what to study, but the Holy Spirit, I was sitting down at my reading table like this, and when the Holy Spirit said to me, I wanted to study English, not just English, but English education. Told me to study English education, and I said okay. He said because of the purpose and destiny I have for you. So I have always known that the Lord had a purpose for me. I'd always known that there was something about ministry. I'd always known, but even though I was not sure specifically what it was going to be or how it was going to be carried out, I just knew that the Lord had his plans for me. And so I was waiting. I pushed myself into a lot of things with that expectation because I just couldn't wait to see, to find myself doing the things that he wants me to do. So in growing up further, I realized that part of the platform to fulfill that ministry would have to be in a place of marriage. Also, it has to be someone that blessing is someone who's going to be also in ministry as well. And the Lord had begun to tell me about the person, about I was speaking to me for over 4 years, for a few years now, about who this person is. He has identified the person to me. He has allowed me to meet with the person. So many things had gone on. And but in this year, and so because the Lord had told me, so I know what responsibilities lies on me, the things I am expected to do, and all the processes the Lord had to take me to, I had walked through that part with him. But when circumstances came up this year, and it felt like everything was delayed. It felt like things were not happening. I had taken steps, and I'm not seeing the manifestation of what the Lord has said. And because it's like with the circumstances that had gone on, I needed this personality to be present. I needed the companionship, because I'm not someone who is everywhere. I don't keep friends. So for me, I just needed my own. So I needed that. But because that was not happening, and it's no excuse, it's no excuse, I found myself in a relationship I shouldn't have been in. And I knew time and time again the Lord told me to walk away. So when I said, for Him to forgive me over and over, there were many things that I just felt like, it was like my heart was rebelling. I know You love me, but why this? I know You said this, but this, I trusted You. I know so many questions going on, and I couldn't voice anything. I couldn't even let my heart think it. I couldn't even let my mind imagine those things, because I needed to honor Him. And then I put myself in a situation that I should not have been in, and I hear the, and every time I felt bad. Situations, and I'll hear the Lord say, I'll come back crying to the Lord, and He says, I forgive you. And then I find myself back again, and I hear the Lord say, and I just believe that for sure He's done with me. And He says, I forgive you, come back, come and continue what we started. And I'm saying, what? So it went on for so long, and I think I got to a point when I told Him, I cannot come out of this by myself. I don't think I have the strength, emotionally or physically or even mentally, to do this. I need You to help me come out of this. And in His loving mercy, He brought me out. He brought me out by Himself. Cut me off from that thing that was going to take me out of His purpose, you know. So I can't speak of everything here because of it could affect a lot of people involved, but I am grateful to the Lord that He forgave me over and over and over again. I'm grateful to Him that, you know, I was reading, yes, it just opened right in front of me, Hebrews 10, and it talks about, I'm using NIV, and it talks about Christ's sacrifice for us once and for all. And then it comes to, I think that should be verse, verse 17. Okay, I'll read verse 16 into verse 17, but verse 17 is my emphasis. He said, this is the covenant I will make. Hebrews 10 verse 16 17, but 17 is the emphasis. And he says, this is the covenant I will make with them after that time, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts, and I will write them on their minds. Then verse 17 went ahead to say, then he adds this. He said, their sins and their lawless acts I will remember no more. He said, their sins and their lawless acts I will remember no more. It's funny how we do things. Even if it is a spouse or someone you're in a relationship with, and you do something over and over and over again, a lot of people will walk away from the relationship, but the Lord did not do that with me. And this is the reason why I've come to say thank you. Why I say I'm thankful to Him for not giving up on me. Rather, for forgiving me over and over again. I'm thankful to Him for forgiving me over and over again. He said, and now he says that my sins and my lawless acts, so those things that I did, those actions I took, those steps, that those things I found myself doing that he was not pleased with, that I knew he was not pleased with, that I knew were wrong. He says that those things, he will remember them no more. That is the reason why I can be here. That's the reason why I can be serving his purpose in ministering to you and to the world, and to be able to share his loving kindness and his mercy today. Because if his mercy, it is an expression of his mercy that he gave me. If I did not experience that, I cannot be here talking to you today. So if you think that the Lord is holding something against you, I'm telling you right now. He says here in Hebrews 10, as long as you have come sincerely, saying that, Lord, I am sorry, I need your help, like I said to you. He says here, he said, their sins and their lawless acts, all the things that you do, you've done. He said, I will remember them no more. This is an expression of his loving kindness and his mercy towards you and towards me. And so if there's someone watching here, you're thinking, but I have done so much. You have no idea. Yours is just maybe just a little time. You don't have no idea, or you don't know what I have done. I'm telling you, go read again. Hebrews 10 from verse 1 up to verse 18. And then focus on verse 17. Jesus has paid it all. And he's asking me to tell you today that he knows that you made wrong, but he loves you and he forgives you. And that is why in Hebrews 10 he talks about the sacrifice that he made for you and for me. He did it all for you, just as he did it all for me. And then he's saying that because of that sacrifice, he will not hold it against you anymore. He will not hold it against me anymore. So every time the enemy wants to put thoughts in your heart, say, because of this, you can get this, is a lie. Jesus finished it off. And just in case you are not sure, he says it in verse 17. I like the way he says it in this NIV. He said, after speaking in verse 16, then he comes to verse 17 and said, then he adds this. So he's saying, okay, I have said this, but I add this to it. Their sins, so you put your name there. Your sins, Judas' sins, Judas' lawless acts. The Lord is saying, I will remember them no more. That means there is no record. It's gone. And that's what the Lord has come to give you today. So if you just say Jesus, if you just say this word with me, Jesus, I thank you for loving me. Thank you for forgiving me for all of my sins. I receive you today as my Lord and my Savior. Thank you for paying the price for me. Please come into my heart. Help me to know you and to know that you love me and you do not hold anything against me anymore. And please help me not to go back to those days. In Jesus' name, amen. So if you've made that prayer, you are now a child of God. You are now a child of God, and Jesus loves you so much. And I love you too. I want to pray for you. Father Lord, I thank you for my brothers and my sister, and anyone who have joined here, or who is still doubting that, whatever she said, how is this possible? Father Lord, there were times I couldn't hold on and you helped me. There were times I couldn't even believe anymore that you still care. But you did everything to let me know that you love me. Father, please help that one who is in doubt. Or who the devil is speaking to their minds. Father, please speak to them and help them to know that just as you helped me, that you are for them and always will be for them. In Jesus' name, amen. So thank you for joining me today on day 6. So expect the next video for the remaining days in December 2023. I love you and God bless you. Bye.